Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. So today we have again a more quick tip than a tutorial. But first of all, congratulations to my French followers on winning the Soccer World Cup. Well done, boys. And now let's start. I want to show what we do today. This quick tip. I got the question, how is it possible to make some such folds here in the bendings? When you animate something, it's easy to make it when you just make this thing here, you paint your things how you need it, and you can paint your a vertex map inside and where you want the folds, or you sculpt it or something else. But if you animate it, it's a little different. So let's see how we do this. It is possible, of course, and yeah, let's start with the cylinder. And here is long here, this is don't want to lock this cylinder wing, let's say 25, and in the plus X. Okay, I don't need any caps here for our tutorial. And we need many of the height segments here, because we want to bend it, and so when we bend something or deform something, we need segments, we need polygons to play with. So let's make it like this. Normally, if you know what you do, so now let's bend this. So I take a bend deformer, I select my cylinder, go to my deformers and shift click on the bend deformer. So because I hold the shift and clicked, so it's becomes a child of this cylinder and fits to the thing here. So of course we have not the right thing, you see it's not the correct direction, so I rotate this 90 degrees here, rotate it here 90 degrees, and this looks better now. Let's say again, bend deformer fit to parent, so make it a little smaller, so something like that, and bend it. Okay. And now we want to have folds here in the inside of the bending. And yeah, we do this with a vertex map, and here I say keep linked axis, so this is, make it even longer, so something like that. Okay, and yeah, we make this with a vertex map, and for a vertex map we need vertices, of course, and so we would have to convert our cylinder. But if you want to stay parametric, like this cylinder, if you don't want to convert it, so there is a way with the correction deformer. But I would say at first bend your things like you want. I made a picture here for testing. So here, you see I make this fold, so and I bended everything, and then I made it editable and bend it then again. So, but if you want to be flexible, more flexible, if you want to change the segments later on or something else, then you can stay like this when you take the correction deformer. And the correction deformer, I bring it under the bend. And now you will see, when I go to my correction deformer and go in point mode, we have points here. So and we can easy select points and everything. And yeah, and we can now play with it, you see. And this, we have it, even we don't converted this cylinder. So, okay, now so let's make it the correction deformer. We have the correction deformer now here, and okay, why not? Next step is we need a tension deck. We use this tension deck in some other tutorials, and you find it under character decks and tension. And we used it until now just with the stretch map every time, but you see we have here a fold map too, and today we use the fold map. And like the word says, okay, This will make faults. On the tension deck. I need the tension deck not on the cylinder because the cylinder don't have vertices, so we need it on the correction deformer. And put it on the correction deformer. And bend, I just lock the bend here, or I make a new window. This is automatically locked. Now you see it on the black lock here. And I see here nothing, so be straight. And on our tension deck, which I lock to here, I say fix the tension on the first position. I fix the tension and say make a fold map. See, now we have a fold map here. If I click on this fold map and on my correction deformer and in the point mode, so fold map, you see the red points here. And as soon as I bend my object now, you see we get yellow points. This means we have, where the points are yellow, it's 100% strength, and on the red points there is nothing. So that means we would have here on the yellow points, when we put this in the displacement, we have on the yellow points we have displacement, and on the other points nothing. But this is too sharp, this transition here. So what you can do is go to the amount, and let's bend this a little more. So to the amount here, and as higher the amount is, as smoother this map will come. So then let's say go to 5. You see, it's a little smoother. And then I think we can go to 8. Maybe this is too much. 7, maybe. We will see it later. We can change this later on. Okay, now we have our map. The next step is, unfortunately, the vertex map does not work with the displace deformer, so we have to make a texture. And for all Octane people, I'm really sorry, but I have no clue how to make this in Octane, because in Octane the displacement does not work with the vertex map. You can use a vertex map in Octane, yes, but it does not work with the displacement. It's only the one that not works is in the displacement. It works with bump, as far as I know, and but not with displacement. So let's make a new material. Put it on my cylinder here. Boing. So we can pick this. So, and now what I do is I go to my luminance channel and just wanna see the faults now. So I don't wanna deform it now. I just wanna see how they would look. So I go to my texture here and go to my noise channel, and I see, okay, we have noise. Noise is a little too big, so let's go to 10. And here in the relative scale, I go to 0. That means I got just stripes. And you see, this would be my faults later on. This is my displacement map, more than less. No, not more than less, it is my displacement map. Maybe a little too big, so I get a 20 here. Okay, this is more I don't have to know. This is okay, so I go back to my color channel, deactivate it, and from the luminance channel I copy out the noise and bring it to the displacement channel. Paste it in here. And I see, okay, this seems not to work. It looks a little weird. So the reason is we have to go here from texture to UV 2D. Then we get something like this. This is quite okay, so I go to subpolygon displacement. And this is too much, let's say 2 should be enough. Looks nice, but we have here some not so nice parts, so the round geometry should help here. And it helps. And but now we want this just on the inside of the bending. It's a little high too, but I go to intensity. Okay. Does not look so bad. So what I do now is I go to my noise. No, not to the noise. I go to my texture and here and take a layer shader and go in my layer shader. Now I have my noise and my layer shader. Next thing is I go to shader effects and for the vertex map. The vertex map I bring under my noise. Whoops. And in the vertex map, of course, we need our vertex map. Why do I have two vertex maps here? Folds, tension. This vertex map I don't need, I think. I need the fold map. Okay, fold map. Oh, I had the other vertex map was when I painted on the vertex on the vertices and made a map, a new map. So, but we need the folds. And it's when you make it with the tension tag, it names it folds, so you know which one is which one. And this I use as a layer mask. So I got a layer mask here, and now you see, I have just on the inside of our thing here, this folds, and when I go back here, I have it here. If I go make it straight, I have nothing. Go and bend it again. So here you have it. And this, of course, you can animate now. And if you animate this, you get what you want. You get the exactly where you need it. And if you have this, you see this shading here. This you can get rid of when you go to the amount of in the tension tag. It's locked, so it's still on the tension tag. But and go with the amount here a little up. So let's try 8. That makes it softer. 9. And with 9, it looks okay. But for me, the folds are a little too narrow, so I make it here a little bigger. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, and that's it. So you can make these folds, and you can not make it only with the bent deformer. You can work with the most spline. Wait, I have to wait. Pause it a second. I'm back in a second. So, yep. Okay, let's make this with a mouse spline. Why not? I'm not so busy that I don't have no time, so don't need this anymore. So, and what can we do? I just copy this whole thing here. Control drag it down, and whoops, bye bye. Don't need anything of this. Okay, we don't need the bent deformer. Good. And we hide it here. Okay. What we want now is to make it with a mouse spline, as I said. So I go to my mouse spline here. I have here my spline now. So, and mouse spline is okay. I've rotated it a little bit, so let's rotate it to 90 degrees here. And now I go to my cylinder and say, I want the deformer and I want the spline wrapper here. Boing. And in the spline wrapper, you see, spline, you put in the mouse spline. Boing. And it's here. So that means when I go to my mouse spline and I play with my mouse spline, a little bit simpler, say curve it, it curves. Which is nice. And exactly what we want. Maybe that we see it better. So you know, go to my mouse spline here and say 90 degrees. So I'm gonna curve it now. Yeah. Okay, so we see it better. And now we can do exactly the same. We have here our tension tag and our vertex map. Let's go here in the mouse spline back to 0. Go to the tension tag and say, but be careful. You see, I have locked my tension tag. That means I'm still on this one here. So if you locked it too, unlock it. Then you click on this tension tag. And now I can lock it again. So it's a code break, it's no problem. Straight everything. And now I say fix tension. And this should do the same like before. Let's see. Yeah, the next step, now it's like this. This is wrong, of course, because we have to go in our material. And of course, we have to change the vertex map too. But it's still this vertex map inside. We need, but we need this vertex map here, the new one. Bring it in, and you see, okay. No faults or something. And now when I go to my mouse spline here and curve it, I again have my nice folds here. And here you can, let's twist it again, let's twist again, so like this. Look what you get, what nice folds you get. It's totally correct and totally great. As I said, I played here with the, oops, this is the wrong one. I played here with this word here. This was just fun. It is just cylinders, with which I used two bent deformer. And but it works everything the same, so makes really fun with this. Looks great. Okay, so you can do this with the fold maps. These are the fold maps, and they are great. Okay, yeah, and as I said, with Octane, maybe if you know how to do this with Octane, please let me know. I have at the moment. I have no idea how it could work with a vertex map, and as far as I know, it does not work with a vertex map and displacement. But maybe you have another idea or something else. So please tell me. But for the physical renderer, it works just perfect. It looks really, really, really fabric-like, so really organic, really nice. Okay, this is it for now, and yeah, sorry that I'm a little busy, but I do my best to bring the tutorials, but I have to work too, you know it, and it's not bad, it's great to have enough work, but sometimes I wish it would be less. Okay. So hopefully I see you in the next, or you watch my next tutorial. Congratulations again to my French follower, and yeah, the next tutorial, maybe I'm not sure, maybe I make one today, but it's 8 p.m. now. I'm not sure, I will see how it will come, but I try it as soon as possible, of course. So okay, then I wish you a nice day, a nice evening, a nice morning, or wherever you are. And if you have requests, complaints, everything, write it in the comments, or please write it on my Facebook site or on my Facebook group, or write me an email, and you will find every link you need in the description of this video. There is also a link for donation if you want to donate. And thanks for the donations. I would know I had last in my last tutorial I said nobody donates. Now there were a few people with donations, and some were really kind, and I say thank you very, very much for this too. And if you want to support me on Patreon, you can do it too, and we'll find the link in the description too. For the Patreons, we'll have some small gifts in the future, so like I make more of my texture pack, and as soon as the version 4 of Octane plugin is out, I will make more with the Octane too, but I don't know what is going on with the version 4, and I don't want to make lots of things for the version 3 or 3.08 or what we have now. And I don't want to make it now, then maybe it's useless, I don't know. And yeah, but there will come something. And yeah, that's it for now. So I wish you all the best, I wish you a nice rest of Sunday, and best regards from here, from Vienna, and yeah, tschüss und Baba.